to Let's Play Clannad Misae Sagara's Path. What did you think of the intro? I hope it doesn't get taken down for copyright as well, but I don't see how it is. It's a wrestler's theme. How could it be taken down just for that? Anyways, I have a little bit of bad news if you... Well, if you take this as bad news. But because, unlike canon, where I, like, fast-forwarded through it all and was unorganized as all hell, you know? What with it, like, going up to 200 parts instead of me splitting it into, like, different paths, so, like, Kyou's path and Ryou's path went up to, like, 61 parts and add a final part, and then Misae's path starts from part 1 on her path, if you get what I'm talking about here. And because of that, there's no telling if there'll be new viewers or anything onto each individual path or whatever. So I'm not going to be skipping anything other than the dream sequence thingies. I will still skip those until Nikisa's path, just what I'd let you know. I might have to point that out every time I start a path, because you never know. Anyway, a world surface of white. Snow. So sorry if it annoys you that we're going through this all over again, but then again, this was a long time ago since we did this part anyway. Yes, snow. Continuing to fall down, even now, it covers my body in white. Ah, what am I doing in such a world? Since when have I been alone in this place? Buried in snow was my hand. That hand was holding something. I pull it up. A hand of pure white. It was a girl's hand. Ah, that's right. I was not alone. I brushed off the snow covering her face. The figure, which slept quietly, surfaced. Oh, I think I kinda know what this is all about. You won't have a clue, probably. But I'm not gonna skip it just because of that, though. That's right. We were always together. In this world. In this sad, lonely world.
Like hell! He's always got someone there for him all the frickin' time, man.
I hate this town. Because it's a place stained with memories I want to forget. Yada yada yada. Every day going to school, chatting with friends, then going to a home I don't like. Hey, it's Shinji Orito! Oh, his name disappeared. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will ever change like this. I wonder if my life will ever be any different.
Well, look at it this way, Tamoya. We've got, I don't know, how many paths left, so your life's gonna be very different from now on, let me tell you. When we get to Sunohara's path, though, it'll be different for the worse, if you get what I mean there.
The untouched and natural growth of this town. The weaving around hills to get to school. I wonder how convenient it would be to attend school if you could wipe off all these hills. If I could take a straight path, it would probably cut down my walking time by 20 minutes. One day, 20 minutes. So then, how much time will I save in a year? I do the math as I walk.
I don't know. And I don't particularly care.
There aren't any other students from my school around. Normally, since this is the main path to school, it should be bristling with life. It's not like today is a holiday or anything. Which means now it isn't a time for people to be arriving at school. I ignore this laid-back image, though, and continue walking at the same speed. 200 meters until I reach the school gates. I stand for a bit.
First sigh of the game!
Well, not really, because we've gone through Kyou and Ryou's path and he did, like, probably 100 sighs. At least. Taking a breath, I look up at the sky.
Presented by Ki. Presented by Ki.
The school gates are just ahead. Who decided to put the gates all the way up there?
Seriously, it wouldn't make any difference, Tamoya. The school is still up there.
This long road is stretching out like a nightmare. Deal with it! It's a different breath from mine. Smaller and more gentle. I look beside me. There's a girl standing as still as I am. I can tell that she's a third-year student by the color of her badge, but she isn't someone I know. Her short hair is fluttering in the wind just above her shoulders. She looks like she's about to cry. I don't usually judge people by appearance, but she looks very honest. She looks like the kind of girl who would be too timid to enter the classroom alone. She closes her eyes and nods repeatedly for a few moments, as if she had something to tell herself. Then she opens her eyes. She looks at the tall school gate with a firm eye.
この学校は好きですか?
A. First A of the game! Well, this path anyway. No, she probably wasn't speaking to me. She was probably talking to someone inside her heart. How would this man, or perhaps woman, answer her?
私はとってもとっても好きです。でも、何もかも変わらずにはいられないです。楽しいこととか、嬉しいこととか、全部、全部、変わらずにはいられないです。
With great difficulty, she continues to speak.
それでも、この場所が好きでいられますか?私は。
You just have to find it, right?
ん?
Surprised, she looks at me, as if she believed that she was alone until now. You just have to find the next fun or happy thing, right? It's wrong to think that there's only one thing like that. That's right. There were times when we were innocent and naive. It's a phase everyone goes through. Come on, let's go. Of course, when they become teenagers, that innocence goes right out the window. And they technically are teenagers. Only they're actually more innocent than normal teenagers. Except for Tamoya. You're not innocent, man! I've seen your dirty thoughts. They... well, okay, maybe it was me, but... yeah, he still has them. The teacher calls out the name of a single student.
相変わらずいないのか?
I glance at Sonohara's seat beside me. His attendance is even worse than mine. We are the only two students in this class known as delinquents. I guess that's why we get along. Also, he's the only person I can really talk to freely. That's how we are. The lesson has started. I spent my time looking out the window, ignoring everything the teacher's saying. Because learning sucks, apparently. I don't really hate learning or anything like that, I just hate sitting in still, like, freaking studying. I hate that. The class has ended and school is over. That Sonohara didn't show up at all. In the end, the only person I talked to today was the girl from this morning. Today is no different from any other day. I'm not part of any club, so I pick up my empty bag and slip out of the classroom while the rest of the students are chatting away. Even if I go home, there won't be anyone there right now. I don't have a mother to begin with. She died in a car accident when I was young. I don't even remember her face. My father, who was left behind, sank into depression, probably affected by the shock of her death. He'd go out, get drunk, and waste his time gambling. My entire childhood was wasted from always fighting with him. But after a certain incident, our relationship changed. He became violent and injured. From that day forward, my father kept his thoughts to himself. Then instead of calling me in the normal way, he started calling me Tamoya-kun, with a kun at the end, as though I were a stranger. Without a doubt, that made us feel unrelated. Just like a closed shell. Just like a point in time that separates the present from the past. It would have been better if he had just completely ignored me. If he cared enough to cause me pain, there would still be hope. But now, if he sees me come home, he smiles as if seeing an old friend and begins to chat. It would cause me so much pain that I couldn't take it anymore. I would rush out of the house. and so in order to avoid him, I have lived my life not returning home till late at night. Like most teenagers, after he was asleep. I go to sleep at dawn and wake up around noon. Ever since I entered high school, I've always been late. This has been going on for 3 years. Today, as always, I changed my clothes and left before my father got home. That's what I've become used to. I roam around the town at night, and I end up going to the same place at the end of the day. I buy my dinner at the convenience store, and with it in hand, I head down the school slope towards the student dormitory. The school activity. They actively promote club activities, so there are a lot of students here. They spend their 3 years here away from their parents. They are very different from a person who lives out his school life with no dreams, like me. It's none of my business, but in this place, he, Sunohara, lives here. Not only that, but our character for this path also lives there. Well, she works there at least, I don't know. Does she live in there as well? Even Sunohara got into this school for sports, as he was once a part of the soccer team. But in his first year, he got into a big fight with students from another school, and got suspended. He was removed from being a regular player. And then, after his freshman year, he lost his place on the team. There was nothing he could do but leave them. As he couldn't really afford to move anywhere else, he ended up remaining in his dorm, which is reserved for students of sports clubs.
How many times do I have to tell you? Makes these parts a little shorter, asshole!
Hey, screw you, man. I'll see you next time.